Making a local multiplayer game in Unreal Engine is easy. Or is it? Let's find out. In this video, we're gonna achieve this. The basis for a local multiplayer game inside Unreal Engine. For this example, I will be using the Stackobot project made by Epic Games. You can get it on FAP. To test the local multiplayer, I will be creating a new open world level. In this new level, I will duplicate this player start the amount of times equals to the number of players that I would like. In my case, 4. These are going to be the starting position of our players. If we only had one, we may not be able to spawn a player on top of another one if something is colliding this player start. Then what I did is create a new game mode class. And inside the game mode, here, class defaults. In the default pawn class, I'm going to set it up as the BP underscore bot. This is our character. To use the created game mode, I'm going to go back to my map. I'm going to click here and change the world override to the game mode that I created. So here you can select it to whatever game mode you have created. Now, when we press play, we should have our character like this. We can move the camera, move around, jump, hold the jump to use the jetpack, and yeah, pretty much just this. To add a new player, I'm going to use the level blueprint just to test through a debug key. Here in the level blueprint, I'm going to add debug key. Whatever letter that you like, I'm gonna use U. Here, whenever we press this, we're going to create a local player. And let's make sure that whenever we create a local player, we are also spawning the player controller with it. Now let's test it. Let's save and compile, and let's go back to the map. Let's press play. And now in the game, press the key that you assigned in the level blueprint. So I'll press U. And a split screen mode has been created. I can move my character, but I cannot move the other one. If I connect my gamepad, which I have, right now I'm still moving the first character. Let's go to the project settings. Here in the project settings, we're gonna need to go to maps and modes. Here in maps and modes, you find this local multiplayer. First, we're gonna check this. If you have a gamepad, you can skip assigning the gamepad to the player one. That way, let me just minimize this. Whenever we play the game and add a new player, now our gamepad will be able to control the one, the player 2, and our mouse and keyboard can actually work with the player 1. Now, there may be a case where you do not want a split screen type of mode. If you do not want it, then let's go back to the project settings. Here, again in the maps and mode, you can untick this. So instead of true, we make it false. And now, whenever we play the game and add another one, we do not get a split screen. This will mean that we will need to create our own camera that will be shared between the players. And I mean, creating one will go out of the scope of this tutorial. But if you want to learn something like this, let me know in the comments below. But yeah, here we can control both of these characters. So let's return our split screen. And you may ask me, hey, what happens if I press my key again? My key to add players. So let's press U and then let's press it again. Well, it's going to create a third one. And if I press it again, it's going to create a fourth one. Here, With my controller, I can move my second player. With my keyboard, I can move my first one. And my third player, I will need to connect a third controller, which let me search if I have one. So I do have one, but it's broken. It only goes forward and to the side. It never goes back. But at least you know that it's working. So what did you think? Easy, right? Well, there are some things you need to have in consideration. By the way, this video is sponsored by us. Check out our action game. And also, we are offering coaching sessions. So don't miss out. The first one is the amount of players. It won't matter if you duplicate the player start however many times you want. If you try to add more than 4 players, you will get a message that you cannot add more. So here I'm trying to add more than 4 players, and in the output log, I will get the message maximum number of players, 4, already created, unable to create more. I also wanted to add that depending on the number of players that you have in your game, your performance may decrease. You are creating 4 viewports, and those viewports need to be rendered. If they all have different cameras, well, you need to take in consideration that you will be rendering 4 times whatever you show on your level. A second thing that you need to watch out is in blueprints, or in any type of code. Let me just open the level blueprint. Every time that you find this node, boop, this node will make reference of the player index. Every time we create a local player, we are assigning it an index. And if it is -1 by default, it's going to assign it the next usable one. We have 0 for player 1, 1 for player 2, 2 for player 3, and 3 for player 4. So whenever we are asking get player controller 0, I'm asking for the player controller of the first player. I cannot use this without thinking about who am I talking about, right? So we may want to replace this with this code. Boop. Instead of just getting the player controller player index 0, I will need a reference to my pawn or character, and from there, I'm gonna get the controller. And if I wanted the character, and I'm using this code, and for this node, I'm gonna stop doing the boop sound because it's even annoying me. So here, get player character, just replace it with this. That way we are able to get the controller or the pawn, which this can also, you can cast it to a character to get the actual character. And if we're talking about just a controller, we can cast it to a player controller, just so we get the information that we need. But the thing will be that it's not going to be that easy. We will need to get a reference to this. And to get the number of players that are currently playing, well, you can use this node. This will return the amount of local players, which are, well, local multiplayer, all of our players, that are currently controlling something. This just means that the players have a device and that device is sending inputs to a player controller. The last thing that you need to worry about is the UI. Let me just open the game mode again. So here, let's edit this game mode. And also in the, where is my player controller? Player controller, I'm going to select the PC underscore in-game. Let's save and compile. And when we test it, we will see that we have UI. Don't press F because it's gonna throw you some errors. I mean, if you want to see me make the Stackobot project into local multiplayer, let me know also in the comments. But here, if I add a new robot, our UI, it's still only working for that player. So it's not exactly what we want. Let's go to the player controller. You can search it in the content browser, content, and just put the name. And here we will see where our UI is being created. And here it is. In the begin play, we have the widget that is being created, and the Add to Viewport. We're going to need to change this node. We're going to use the Add to Player Screen. This is the node that we are going to replace our Add Viewport with. With this change made, if we play the game, we're gonna get an error, and that's because we're creating the player on the fly. And this code, instead of using the begin play, we should be using the onPossess. So let's go here. Here it is, onPossess, this one. And let's just put it here. Just break the link, connect it like this. And now, when we test the game, let's press our key, and everyone gets its own UI. And because everyone gets its own player controller, make sure that if you want to save specific data of the player, you can do it either in the character, or the player controller, or even better, in the player state. And that's what I wanted to talk about today. I'm not an expert on this type of games, but I'm sure that this video can help you get started. Just keep in mind that whenever you have your own game, you probably won't want to spawn your players through a key press, right? You really won't want that. You will probably need to use a menu in a level and save the number of players that you will want to have, and maybe give them names, right? Save that into the game instance, and then in your level, load that data from the game instance, and depending on the number of players that you captured, then you can actually create those players at the start of the game. So yeah, I mean, again, this is just a YouTube tutorial. I really don't have that much time to go into it, but if you would like to, for me to get into that, yeah, just leave me a comment below. Thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next one.